सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिप्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहा दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तुमा विद्युषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माण विदातिगुरो यदागश्च बृह्णोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः अम्नयन्ति संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे The next sutra, 3362 says, Shishtheshcha. It was introduced by the Siddhanti's objection to the Purvapakshi's sutra. Purvapakshi is saying that all the upasanas are angas to the anga of the karma. Because they are Angashrita Upasanas. So the Vidyas Upasanas which are Angashrita in Udgita Ityadi Upasanas where you have to do Kalpana of parts of the karma in the Upasana. Between the parts Anga and the main karma there is already anga angi bhava. So if you are imagining that vidya upasana will also have to be the anga to the main karma via the anga of the main karma. So the anga shrita will also become anga of the primary karma. This is his claim, and therefore he says samuchaya is to be done. You have to club together all upasanas with the karma, angashrita upasanas. So angeshu yathashraya bhava is the claim that he has made, to which the Siddhanti objected, saying that if you say that all the angashrita upasana, because they have ashraya on the anga or have or anga tantra, have connection and dependency on the anga of the karma, therefore they also have to become anga, then Godahana Patra, which is ordained in the place of Chamasa only for one who is Pashukama, that will also become Samuchita. It will also become combined and everyone will have to use Godahana Patra instead of Chamasa. That is not the case, however. So nanu tari godahanasyapi samuchaya niyama syad ityatah. So if the Siddhanti were to object that godahana patra will also become anga to the main karma and everyone will have to follow, to that the Purvapakshi replies ityatah shishtheshcha. He says, and due to shishti is sasana. Due to Shruti Vakya. Shruti is the Pramana there. Purvapakshi also says that Shruti is the Pramana. The way you say Darshanat Ityadi, Shishti, the teaching in the Shruti is not the way Siddhanti considers, says the Purvapakshi. We'll see what it means in the Sutra, in the Vritti. Shishte hai Shasanat, meaning Vidhanat. Because there is Vidhana. What is the Vidhana? Vidhana is of Chamasa. So Chamasa Vidhana is there. Omkara Vidhana is there. So wherever there Omkara Vidhana is there, as to the Omkara being part of Udgita, but still that Udgita being part of Karma, Anga of Karma, Omkara is also part of Karma. So when you have Omkara Upasana also, then that will also become part of karma. Omkara is not listed, meaning the upasana is not listed as an anga of the karma. But you will have to make it so. Why? Because he says this Godohana Patra is given as a vidhi. As an anga, chamasa has been ordained. In the place of the anga, Godohana Patra has been ordained. So when you compare with upasanas, upasanas are not ordained in the place of anga of the karma, but they are ashrita on the anga. So if you are doing the anga, then the ashrita will be dragged automatically. Shruti has not given a vidhi there. However, with Godohana Patra, there is a vidhi in the place of chamasa. Therefore, it becomes a vikalpa now. So you can have chamasa also or Godohana also. There is no samuchaya there. But in the case of upasana, where there is no vidhi as in the place of anga, there samuchya has to be done. This is the claim of the Purvapakshi. Shishtehe shasanat vidhanat vihitatva avisheshat. Godohana patra is vihita, whereas upasana is not vihita in the place of anga. Vihitatva avisheshat angavat samuchya ityartha. Therefore, the upasanas are to be taken as anga, angavat samuchya. But Godohana Patra is not so. Further, he explains, Godohanasya chamase vihitatvat. The Godohana Patra is ordained in the place of chamasa. So, Godohana is the patra where you milk the cow. That is given as an option by the Shruti. It is ordained by the Shruti for Pashukama. Godohanena Pashukamasya. So, one who is wanting Pashu as Dhana, it is a vidhi for him, not for others. So chamase vihitatvat, it has been ordained in the place of chamasa. Therefore, na samuchaya anushthana niyama. So only for Pashu Kama it has been ordained in the place of what is already ordained for others. Therefore, chamasa vishaye, in the place of chamasa, sorry. Therefore, what? This shishtescha vihitatvat, that's what it means. He sums it together as the sutra says, shishtescha, so vihitatvat, na samuchaya anushthana niyama. There is no possibility of combining Godohana also in the karma. By everyone, it is not needed. However, in the case of upasana, upasti or vidya, what is the issue? Upasti namtu. So on the other hand, upasti, upasana astu kasyachid angasya sthane vihitatvat. Upasti nam kasyachid angasya sthane upasti namtu kasyachid angasya sthane vihitatva. Just give me one moment. Avihitatva should be there. Split would be avihitatvat, I think, because it is not ordained in the place of anga. Kaschit angasya sthane avihitatvat. So you can read a engapada, you can read an avagraha here and split that, because that's what it appears to be. See, godohanasya chamese vihitatvat and upasthinam tu, it is in contrast. So avihitatva should be the reading. In the book, I don't find avihitatva. It is vihitatva itself. Let me just see if there is another option possible. Give me a moment. So avihitatva, I would read it so. you should read an avihitattvat here. Because there is a contrast being shown, there won't be any contrast and it won't make sense if it is vihitattvat. Because if it is vihita, then there will be combination. If there is no vidhi, meaning if it is given as a vidhi, then you have to go as per the vidhi. There is no vidhi as a replacement of the anga. So upasti naam tu kasyit angasya sthane avihitatvat. It is not ordained in the place of any anga. It is dependent on the anga because it is anga ashrita. So there is ashraya ashrayi bhava. The upasana is ashrita on the anga of the karma, which is ashraya. So upasti naam tu kasyit angasya sthane avihitatvat. Samuchaya niyamaha na virudhyate iti bhava. Therefore you can do samuchaya. You will not be replacing any anga. In the case of godohana, if you do samuchaya of godohana patra, then chamasa is already ordained. What do you do with that? You cannot have both. So Purvapakshi is saying that either you will have godohana patra or chamasa. So there is a vidhi to replace chamasa patra. In the case of upasana, there is no such vidhi. You are not going to replace any anga. So you can do the angi, anga, all the angas and additionally upasana, which are ashrita on the karmanga. So there is no vidhi to replace. There is a vidhi of upasana, that's all. So vidhi of upasana is also subsidiary to the anga, which is subsidiary to the angi. Therefore, all can be done together. There is no samuchaya virodha. Samuchaya niyama virodha is not there. So samuchaya niyama can still be there. There is no virodha. The way there is virodha in godohana and chamasa going together, such virodha is not there with upasana and the anga of the karma on which the upasana is ashrita being done together. There is no such virodha at all. So logically it makes sense, says the Purvapakshi. Samuchaya lingamaha. What is the linga for samuchaya? It becomes a hetu as to why there is angangi bhava between the upasanas and the karmangas. Samaharat, samaharat. So it is also Purvapaksha Sutra, samaharat. Because there is samahara combination of omkara elsewhere, you see. Omkara which is spread across the shakhas of various Vedas, all those omkaras are one and the same. So we club them together. The omkara understanding is from all places. So whether it is a Rigveda Antargata Omkara or Samaveda Mantra Antargata Omkara, they are the same Omkara. So that kind of Samahara tells you that the karma, how the mantras are understood together. And in karma also, it's the same Omkara as an Anga of the karma, because mantra is also part of the karma. So if one is doing Sama, Shakha mantra chanting as part of the karma, then the Rigveda Antargata Omkara is also being chanted. There is no difference in Omkara. There is combination samuchaya there. So the pranava or Omkara is combined across. Similarly, all the angas have to be combined, whether they are in your shakha or elsewhere. Vidyas are anga, and therefore they have to be combined together. Samahara, samuchaya has to be done. Upasana also being angashrita. They are not angas. For the anga, the hetu is given that it is angashrita. Omkara is also like that. So when omkara, pranava is combined, why not angashrita upasanas? This is the Purvapakshi's argument. Hotru shatanadhaiva api, hotru shatanadhaiva api, Durudgitam anusamaharati iti Rigveda ukta pranavasya samveda ukta udgitena aikya upasti balad udgatra pramadad drishtasya api udgitasya samyak kruta hotru samshanataha samahara nirdosha karanad ityartha. So the argument is not that Omkara is one and the same directly. He is saying Omkara is one and the same we land on through Linga. So what is the Linga? How did he interpret that, Purvapakshi interpret that Omkara across the Shakhas is one and the same? He says there is a mantra which says what? In Chandogya, Hotru Shadana Dhaivapi. Hotru Shadana, Hotru Shadana, Sadana. What is Hotru Shadana? This Ru has caused Sakara to become Murdhanya, Shakara. आदेश प्रत्ययो हो इनको हो अपदांतस्य सकारस्य मूर्धन्यः. सो दिस सदन इज स्तुति. सो होत्रु सदन इज स्तुति होत्रु सदनाद. सो होत्रु स्तुते है ड्यू टू दी स्तुति बीइंग डन बाय होता. होता इज डूइंग दी होम, होम कर्म, याग कर्म. एंड देर इज अ ब्रह्मा सिटिंग हु इज overseeing everything. He is overseeing whether Hota, Udgata, all these, they are doing their work properly or not. So Brahma is one who knows all the four Vedas, and he will know the entire karma in and out. Then further, Udgatra is singing Udgana. He is singing Udgana, Sama. He is singing Sama, and when he is doing Sama chanting, which has Omkara, there in that Sama chanting, if he makes a mistake, in Udgana he makes some mistakes, then in the Homa it will be corrected by the Hota, who is also using Omkara. So the Hotru Shadana, in the due to Hota doing the Stuti in the Karma, Eva Api Durudgita. Durudgita is what? These singing which is having flaws, Udgana, Samagana which is having some flaws, Anusamaharati. So the Hota singing, due to Hota singing itself, Durudgita will be corrected. This is what the Chandogya mantra says. Iti Rugveda Ukta Pranavasya. The Stuti has Pranava, Rugveda, which the Hota is chanting. So Rugveda Ukta Pranavasya Samaveda Ukta Udgitena Aikya Upasti Balad. How does that happen? How does the truti, how do the flaws get corrected? Because the Rugveda Ukta Pranava Omkara in the Rugveda Mantra, Samaveda Ukta Udgita, that Udgita also what? Udgita where Omkara Drushti is there. Sorry, Omkara where Udgita Drishti is there. That was taught earlier in the Upasana. So that Upasana is strong enough to combine this Rugveda Omkara and Omkara which is ordained in the Upasana of the Udgita. Udgita Upasana. So Samaveda Ukta Udgitena Aikya Upasti Balad. Such Upasana has been ordained. So the Omkara, which is part of Udgita, which is part of Sama, in that Omkara there is Udgita Drishti. So the Omkara in the Sama has become one with the Pranava Omkara in Rigveda, chanted in Rigveda by the Hota. So the Udgana Karta, who may or may not be doing the Upasana, but that Upasana Bala is such that the Omkara there has been, is being seen as Udgita, and that Udgita is being sung by the Udgata. That Omkara which is Pranava in the Rugveda is one and the same. Due to that Upasana Bala, Udgita Drishti is there in Omkara, that Omkara is same across. So much thinking has gone in, and thereby what? Udgatra Pramadad Drishtasya Api. Dushtasya api udgitasya samyakrita hotru samsanataha. So Hota is doing the karma where he is chanting Omkara. That Omkara is not separate. It is one with the Omkara where the udgita drishti is ordained in the upasana, and that very udgita is being chanted by the udgata in his sama chanting in that singing, if he has made some dushta pronunciation, some wrong pronunciation, then pramada, due to negligence, pramada dushtasyapi udgitasya, that dushta udgita also will become samyakruta. Samyakruta hotru samsanata. It will be corrected by the hota doing his job properly. Samyakruta. Hotru samsanataha. Kim bhavati? Samahara. Thereby samahara. There is combination of the omkara. And this omkara is taught as udgita in the upasana. Therefore, there is combination of that upasana also. Otherwise, this flaw cannot be corrected. The omkara which is same in the yajushaka is also being seen as udgita by the upasaka who follows the samashaka. If the omkaras were separate, then his drishti of omkara, the udgita in omkara would be specific omkara which is separate from the yajurveda omkara. If it is separate, then how will Yajurveda Hota chanting and doing stuti and doing his, you know, ahuti, etc., how would that correct the flaw of the Samaganakarta, Udganakarta? Won't be possible. So this becomes a linga that they are one and the same. Although the Omkara is very specific as a part of Udgita, which is part of Sama, still that Omkara cannot be separate from the Yajushaka Antargata Omkara. Otherwise, this kind of a statement won't make sense. Therefore, Omkaras being one, the Upasana where Omkara is seen as Udgita, which is the Hetu, which is the Linga for this, that also shows there is oneness in Angangi Bhava. They are all Upasanas should be combined here as well. Vidhikarma, Karma, Anga Ashrita Upasanas. Evancha Veda Dvayo Samahara Samaharat Nirdosha Karana Dityartha. So Samaharat means they have been come to club together, and having club together, what is really being done? Nirdosha Karana Dityartha. The dosha of the Udgana has been taken away by the Hota because the Omkaras are one, and the Omkara which is ordained as Udgita in the Sama. Evancha Veda Dvayokta Pranavodgithayoho Aikya Jnanasya Etadrusham Phalam Bruvat Chandogya Vakyam Sarva Veda Uktanam Api Angashrita Upasthinam Sambandha Samanyat Samuchchailingam Iti Bhavaha. So why some kind of a methodology Purva Pakshi has landed on combination of all sorts of Upasanas which are Angashrita with the Anga, with the Angi also. Evancha. So in this manner, what will happen is a Veda Dvaya Ukta Pranava. Pranava Omkara is there in Yajur Veda also and in Sama Veda also. So Veda Dvaya Ukta, what has been stated, Pranava is chanted. So Pranava Omkara, Pranava Udgita Yoho, and Udgita is what? Pranava in Yajur Veda, that Omkara is being referred as Pranava. And Udgita is what? Udgita Drishti is there in Omkara, which is part of Udgita in the Upasana in Sama. So Pranava Udgita Yo Aikya Jnanasya. Once you know that this Pranava in Omkara in Yajurveda is same as Udgita Omkara in Sama Shaka, then Aikya Jnanasya Etadrusham Phanam. What is the resultant of having such aikya jnana between the two omkaras which are across shakhas, across Vedas, etadrusham phalam, this is the phala which is already analyzed, meaning nirdosha karanam. And that chandogya vakya which is saying that, the chandogya 155 which say, so phalam bruvat chandogya vakyam, bruvat is shatranta. So that statement, that vakya, chandogya vakya, which says this, while saying this, stating this result of samahara, meaning nirdosha karana, truti being corrected, flaws being corrected in Udgana by the Hota, how stating this Aikya. It is becoming a linga to show the Aikya also between Omkaras across these Vedas. Sarva Vedoktanam Api Angashrita Upasthinam. That Vakya is what? Lingam. Samuchaya Lingam. Lingam for what? For Samuchaya. So Sarva Veda Uktanam Api Angashrita Upasthinam Sambandha Samanya. Because the Sambandha is Samanya, Samanyas have been clubbed together, then Sambandha Samanya will make this Upasana also to be brought into the Samuchaya. So Sambandha Samanya Samuchaya Lingam. So while saying that these Omkaras are one, although they are across Shakhas and there is Upasana ordained which is a Linga as well, therefore this Vakya will become Linga for what? To club the Upasana also with the Karma. Thereby Sambandha Samas Samuchya Lingam iti Bhavaha. It indirectly shows that Upasanas also have to be clubbed together. Which are the ones? Showing the Omkara as one, and thereby such correction of flaws are possible. Therefore, Upasanas cannot stay separate. Those Upasanas which have become an indicator are themselves going to be part of the Anga of the main karma. Lingantaramapyaha. Purvapakshi says, I'll show you another Linga also. Another indicator as to why this Upasana has to be one. Give me one moment. Is there anything else there? So Angashrita Upasana. For that Samuchaya, there is another Linga. Lingantaramapi Aha Gunasadharanya Shrutescha. Gunasadharanya Shrutescha. So he's already shown Sambandha Samanya. So Samanya Sadharana. So he says Gunasadharana Shrutehe Cha. And also due to Gunasadharana. What is a guna sadharana? Omkara is gauna. In Upasana, the Omkara is not really Udgita. It is part of the Udgita, which is part of Sama. In that Omkara, there is Udgita Drishti Vidhana. Udgita Drishti Vidhana. So Upasana is ordained in the Omkara, which is gauna. It is not, there is a Gauna Prayoga as to Omkaram Udgita Upasita. So Omkara has to be seen as Udgita itself. That is not main. Main, it is not really Udgita, but you have to see it as Udgita. Therefore there is a Gauna Prayoga. Gauna, meaning Gaunatvam is there. Upasyatvena Gaunatvam. Kasya Omkarasya. Omkara, which is what? Udgita avayavasya omkarasya upasyatvena gaunatvam. And that gaunatvam is sadharana. So guna means gaunatva. Gaunatva being there. Guna sadharanya shrutescha. Due to this, what will happen? In the pradhana udgita upasana, the part of the udgita is being seen as omkara, which is part of the Udgita, is being seen as Udgita itself. That is one way to look at it. Second is, the Anga Karmas which are Gauna. Anga Karmas, because Anga is Gauna. Pradhana is the Angi. So Angas are Gauna. How Gauna Angas are, or rather Gauna Karmas, how Gauna Karmas are becoming Anga to the Angi, similarly this Gauna Upasana, which is Angashrita, where there is Guna being talked about of the Omkara, Upasyatvena Gaunatvam. So Gaunatvam is Prapta there as well. So that Gauna is going to have a dependency on Pradhana. Therefore this Gauna Upasana, like the Gauna Karma, will have Anga Angi Bhava with the Pradhana Karma. Pradhana Karma will become Angi. So this is how Purvapakshi is looking at another Linga. Guna Sadharanya Shruteshcha. So wherever there is Gauna Karma, it cannot be done independently. Gauna Karma, all the Gauna Karmas will become Anga to the Pradhana Karma. That is the difference between pradhana and gauna. Similarly here, this gauna upasana, guna saman, sadharanya shruti, because of guna sadharana, as seen in the shruti, the gauna upasana will also become anga to the pradhana karma. Why are the anga, karma anga? Because it is an ashrita upasana. So this is the sutrartha. Tena omkarana vedatrayoktam karma bhavati iti udghito upasto gunabhutasya upasasya omkarasya sarva karmani sadharanya shravanat tad ashrita upastina api sadharanyam samuchya anushtanam ityartha. And what we saw earlier also, omkara is what? Omkara is part of all shrutis. So tena omkarana vedatrayoktam karma bhavati. So omkara is being used as what? As a part of karma. In which karma? In all karmas across all Vedas. So Veda Trayoktam Karma Tena Omkarena Bhavati. Omkara is being used there. Iti Udgita Upasto Gunabhutasya Upasasya. This Udgita, in the Udgita Upasana, there is Gaudatva, Upasyatvena Gaudatva of Omkara. Because Omkara is not really Udgita, but there is a upasyatvena gaunatvam praptam. Therefore, this omkara which is used in all Vedas as part of karma, this upasana where the omkara, udgita upasana where omkara has guna bhava, also will become part of the karma. Just like omkara na vedatrayuktam karma bhavati. Omkara is part of the karma, anga, it is anga of all karmas also. In all three Veda, similar this Omkara where the Upasana is ordained as Udgita will also becoming Gauna be part of Karma as well. There will be Anga Angi Bhava. Guna Bhutasya Upasasya Omkara is a Sarva Karmani Sadharanya Shravana. The same Omkara is heard in all the Vedas, Vedatraya, where they are part of the Karma. So Sadharanya Shravana Tad Ashrita Upasthinam Api Sadharanyam Samuchya Anushthanam Ityartha. Therefore the Upasanas which are ashrita in karma angas, which are part of all three Vedas, what will happen? There is a sadharanyam now. And thereby samuchya anushthana is definitely there. Samuchyena anushthana niyama asti. This is what Purvapakshi is saying. You see that omkara everywhere is one and the same. A shortcut method is omkara everywhere is one and the same. He is already established in one way in the earlier sutra. Now he is saying this guna sadharana gaunyatvam is praptam in omkara, which is this udgita omkara or upasti omkara, upasana antargata omkara, udgita upasana antargata omkara. So therefore this gauna bhava will also tell you that there is anga bhava, and therefore samuchya anga cannot stay separately. Yadva or what? Guna sadharanya shrutecha yadi सर्वेषां कर्मगुणानां उद्गीतादीनां समुच्चित्य अनुष्ठानात्मक साधारण्यं न स्यात् तर्हि तदाश्रित उपास्थीनामपि समुच्चित्य अनुष्ठानं न स्यात्. सो ही इज टेकिंग दी हैड इट नॉट बीन सो देन देयर वुडंट हैव बीन दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कंक्लूजन. सो व्हाट इज ही सेइंग रियली? यद्वा अदरवाइज गुण साधारण्य श्रुतेश्च मीनिंग व्हाट? यदि सर्वेषां कर्मगुणानां उद्गीतादीनां समुच्चित्य अनुष्ठानात्मक साधारण्यं न स्यात्. Had there not been sadharanya, meaning samuchaya, samuchaya sadharana, the anushthana by clubbing together, had it not been the perspective of the shruti, samuchaya of what? Karma gunana, all the udgita adinam. So udgita ityadi, if udgita omkara was not one with the veda trayukta omkara, so had the omkara not been karma guna, so all the sarveshan karma guna, wherever you have gauna karma or udgita ityadi omkara, so omkara also being part of all mantras across all karmas across all shakhas across all Vedas, then had there not been samuchaya there, then नस्यात् तर्हि तदाश्रित उपास्तीनामपि समुच्चित्य अनुष्ठानं न स्यात्. then what you the Siddhanti is claiming that the Ashrita Upasanas are not having Samuchya with the Pradhana and its Angas, that would have been so. Had there been no Karma Guna Udgita Adi Samuchya, but there is Samuchya. Natva Etarasti, it is not so. Meaning it is not so that there is no Samuchya of Karma Gunas. Angas are always together with the Angi, so wherever there is Gauna Bhava, they will become Anga to the Pradhana of all karmas. So whichever karma is Gauna, that will become Anga to the Pradhana. So Anga Angi Bhava will be there. So Samuchya has to be done. You cannot say that, oh, I'll not do this, I'll do one, I'll pick. There is no Vikalpa. Similarly, this Udgita also is what? Udgita is Anga. How is Udgita not Anga? It is Anga of Sama, and Samak, you are doing the karma. So Udgita is already Anga of the karma, Sama karma. Now this, if this Udgita is already Anga, then how can the Omkara, which is part of Udgita, where Udgita Drishti is ordained, how can that Upasana remain separate? It has become, it and is Gauna. So because of this Upasana also becoming Gauna with the Guna, Gauna is also what? Gunasya Bhava Gauna, so Gaunyam. So the Gaunatva is Prapta in the Upasti Omkara, Udgita Omkara. So Udgita being part of Karma, the Upasana also will become part of Karma. Anga, Anga to Karma, part of Karma means Karma, there will be Pradhana. So it will be Anga Angi Bhava. So Natu Etarasti, there is no Samuchya Bhava. Udgita is not separate, it is a Karma Guna. So being Anga, Natu Etarasti, Samuchya is not there, is not there. Meaning there is a double negation. It is not that there is no Samuchya, meaning there is Samuchya. All Karma Gunas, such as Udgita, etc., they are part of Pradhana Karma. Therefore, Prayoga Vachena Sarvanga Grahinam Tesham Sadharanya Shravanat. Therefore, why? Natu Yedarasti. Why? He is giving Hetu. Prayoga Vachena. In the Prayoga, you have Udgita. You are doing the Karma. Udgita is there. Sama chanting is there. Udgita is there. Udgita Antargata Omkara is also there. So, Prayoga Vachena Sarvanga Grahinam. All the Angas are grasped by this. Karma itself, Tesham Sadharanya Shravanat. All of them have to be clubbed together. You cannot keep the Upasana separate. Tatascha Tadashita Upasthinam Api Sadharanyam Ityartha. So now there is a common statement. Everything that is Guna, subsidiary, has to be clubbed together. Upasana Antargata Omkara is there, on which there is a Omkara, Udgita, Drishti ordained as Upasana. Udgita is already part of Karma. So Upasana will also become part of Karma. Why? Because Sadharanyam. There is Sadharanyam. Both are. There is no difference between Udgita, which is Guna, Karma Guna, and Udgita Antargata Omkara, where Udgita Drishti is ordained. It cannot remain separate. There is Sadharanyam. Evam Pura Pakshi Siddhanta. There are only two sutras. I'll finish this and we'll complete this pada. Evam Pura Pakshi Sati Siddhanta. What is the Siddhanta now? All these are Pura Paksha sutras. Siddhanti is taking what he has already explained. He says that all this Dravida Pranayama that you are doing is all not needed. We have already explained in multiple steps. Now we'll club together and give a summary as to what it means. Nava tat sahabhava shrutehe. Nava tat sahabhava shrutehe. Nava tat sahabhava shrutehe. Ashrutehe. Nava. So, va here is in va shabda tu artha, tu artha. So, the va should be understood as tu, natu. It is not so. Purva Pakshi has said in so many sutras, all that is erroneous conclusion. Why? Tat sahabhava ashrutehe. The upatat is angashrita upasana. Angashrita tat sahava tesham sahabhava ashrutehe. Meaning Samuchya Ashrute. There is no Shruti which gives you a Samuchya of Angashrita Upasana with the Anga and the Angi. There is no such Shruti at all. So all these Lingas won't work. because we have already shown how those lingas will not work. We have shown how the upasanas are separate. So if you say other lingas will prove so, none of those will be strong pramana. Further we will see in the vritti. Va shabdaha tvartaha tu artha. So tu iti artha yasya va shabdasya saha va shabdaha tvartaha. So it's a bahuri. This tvartha is bahuri. So va shabda is that which has va iti shabda karmadhare. Va iti shabda va shabdaha. Then tvartha means what? Tu iti artha yasya. Yasya kasya va shabdasya. The va which has the meaning of tu is called as tvartha. So va shabda is called as tvartha. Purva paksha nirasartha. So tu artha meaning it has a meaning of tu. So it is to say that oh natu tatha asti, it is not so. Purva paksha nirasa is being done. Purva paksha is being refuted by that. Na. Na what? Na angashrita upasti nam angavat samuchya niyamaha. There is no samuchaya of angashrita upasanas like the angas. Angavat. Anga angi have samuchaya. But angashrita upasanas do not have samuchaya. Why kutaha? Tat sahabhava ashruti. How is the sahabhava shruti going to be pramana? Elsewhere we see graham vagrihitva ityadina yatha anganam sahabhava shruyate. How do you have anga angi bhava between the subsidiary karma and the pradhana karma? How do you see the subsidiary being a subsidiary in any other karma? Because graham vagrihitva, having picked up the patra, some kind of a statement is there. So when you are doing a karma, such as what? Achamya. So achamya etat kuriya. So you do something after doing achamana. So achamana being becomes an anga to that karma. How do you know? Because there is a some mantra like that. So graham va grihitva, this step, picking up something and approaching something, walking towards something, all this will be mentioned. So thereby you know that process also, and whatever you use, you lift up something, etc., all that will become anga to the karma. So pradhana karma will be there, and thereby some steps will be mentioned. You do this. While doing this, whatever ingredients or whatever dravyas you are using, whatever patra you are using, all that will become, all those will become anga. Ityadina yatha anganam sahabhava shruyate. So there should be a shruti which will drag that part or process as anga into the pradhana karma. In the steps of the pradhana karma, everything will be included now. Tadvat tasam upastinam sahabhavasya ashrute. There is no such, during the karma, there is no such statement found as to you should do this upasana. Udgita upasita, omkaram udgita. Such statement is not heard while doing the karma. It is all outside. So during the upasanas, karma antargata, whatever steps are there, those are heard. As to what you imagine this kind of a karma, you imagine this kind of a karma. So there is no upasana being ordained during the karma. Upasana is separate, where the steps of the karma are recollected and you imagine. So there is absolutely no connection there. Connection is only the proximity whereby you can know the details of the karma and bring into the upasana in a right manner, in the right structure, in the right sequence also. Therefore they are proximal, but does not make the upasana anga. For that there should be a shruti which drags the upasana, without which that step is not complete in the pradhana karma. There is no such step which is incomplete without this udgita drishti ityadi in the omkara. There is no such karma mantra at all. There is nothing like that. So tadvat tasa upasinam sahabhavasya ashruti. There is no such shruti at all. How will you make it an anga? When will you do it? The question is, when will you do it? Because all that, when something has to be done, in which way you will know from the upasana, but when it has to be done is not there at all. So will you do at the beginning, in middle somewhere, or at the end? There is no such thing at all. You have to imagine the anga also. Anga angi bhava is imagined. So nacha anga tantratvad upasthinam samuchya niyama iti sampratam. So therefore It is very well analyzed by us and concluded, says the Siddhanti, that Angatantratvad, nacha Angatantratvad, because of Upasanas having dependency on the steps of the Anga, of the Pradhana Karma Anga, how it is to be done, all that you learn in the Karma, just because of that, Upasinam Samuchya Niyama Nasti. Just because of that, Samuchya Niyama is not there. Iti Sampratam, this is very well concluded by analysis, Angatantrasyapi Godohanasya Anushthana Niyamaditi Dik. And Purapakshi is reminded, we have already objected to what you have said, but your reasoning for Godohana being ordained in the place of Chamasa, all that is not logical, because your reasoning as to why you are making the Upasanas as part of Anga is because Anga Tantra. You are making it as part of primary karma is because it is Anga Tantra. Anga Tantra is the Hetu. Now you cannot jump the Hetu and say, oh, there is a Vidhi there in the place of Chamasa. None of that is a reasoning. It is not Mimamsa. Anga Tantra was your Hetu for Upasana to be part of Karma as Anga. So to Godohana is Anga Tantra. It is dependent on the Chamasa, which is Anga. Instead of that, you have to use Godohana. So Godohana is also Anga Tantra. It has dependency on the Anga. It will also become Samuchita. But it is not so. So Godhanasya Anushthana Aniyamad Iti Dikyo. So sufficient discussion has gone by. He says it is enough. Iti Dik, it is enough. You can revisit what we already said, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi. There is no such, the way Godohana Patra does not become part of the karma complete, Samuchya is not there. Similarly, Angatantratvad, that Hetu won't work in the case of Upasana also to be dragged into Samuchya. There is no combination. Final sutra in the Pada is Darshanachya, Darshanachya, and also due to Darshana, Shruti. Shruti is the Pramana. What is that? Evam Vidhavai Brahma Yajnyam Yajamanam Sarvaschartvijo Virakshati Iti Shrutavanga Ashrita Upasinam Asamuchaya Darshanat Iti Atishobanam. So earlier this Sampratam Shobanam kind of a meaning, Atishobanam. There is absolutely no doubt as to our analysis has led to a proper Mimamsa and conclusion, says the Siddhanti. Why? Darshanacha. Due to Darshanacha, due to Shruti Vakya itself. What is the Shruti Vakya that shows there is no Samuchaya, Asamuchaya? Evam Vidha Vai Brahma. The Brahma who is presiding over all the karmas, who knows all the Vedas, what does he do? Yajnyam Yajamanam Sarva Cha Ritvijaha Abhirakshati. He protects Abhirakshati. So Brahma protects the Brahma Yajnyam Yajamanam. He protects the Yajna, Yaga going on, Yajamana who is officially getting the Yaga done, and all the Ritviks, all the priests who are participating, he protects all of them. How does he protect? So Brahma knows the entire karma and has Upasana Shakti also. So he is protecting all of them. If they make some mistakes, then there are some ways to protect. If Brahma himself makes some mistake, then with his Upasana Shakti itself, he will correct. In Chandogya, all this is detailed as to how, what has to be done. So there, as I mentioning earlier, in the 5th chapter, there are some, you know, Bhuswaha Ityadi, when Bhuvaswaha, Suvaswaha, so some Ahutis are to be given. So Brahma protects, and then Brahma protects by his own Shakti. So now if Upasana is part of karma, then all these who are doing karma, Yajamana knows the karma somewhat, and Ritviks know the karma. Ritviks do not know the Upasanas. If the Upasana is part of the karma, then Ritvik will also know the Vidya. If Ritvik knows the Vidya and all the Ritviks, Yajamana, all of them who know the karma, what they have to do, if all of them knew, they have to know all the Angas, and if the Upasana is an Anga, then all of them will know the Upasana also. That Upasana which gives the phala of protection, protection, or which gives a supreme phala, that kind of an upasana which is known to everyone and they are doing it, because if it is an anga, then they have to do it as well. So if they are doing the karma and they are doing the upasanas also, why would they need protection of Brahma? They are already protected. They won't need protection of Brahma by his own upasana and sarvajnyatvam. He is sarvajnya as regard to that complete, because he knows all the Vedas, he knows the entire karma, he knows the upasanas which are to be done. So that's how he has become Brahma. That is how it should be. Today anyone and everyone is a Brahma, so they may take turns also. You be Brahma in this, I'll be Brahma in the other one. That may go on because of the study lacking in Vaidika karma also. So here, just give me one moment. I'm late for the other part. I'll just mention. Just mention there. I'll end this, but I. Lost the address book. Okay, so Abhirakshati, that wouldn't have been valid. That statement is made in Chandogya. So iti shrutau angashrita upasti nam asamuchya darshanat. You see, there is no samuchya. Had there been samuchya, then such statement makes no sense. If there is samuchya, then why will Brahma do Abhirakshana? All of them are doing upasanas, they don't need Brahma to do Abhirakshana. So Brahma does Abhirakshana means there is no samuchaya of the upasana. Darshana iti atishobanam. So this is completely correct analysis and conclusion as per Mimamsa Shastra we have followed. Iti Shri Brahma Tattva Prakashikayam Tritiya Adhyasya Tritiya Pada. Thereby the third pada is over in the third chapter. We'll continue with the fourth pada, last pada in the third Adhyaya, in the it's a large pada as well. So the third chapter, as I said, it is quite a large chapter. Fourth chapter is a phaladhyaya, it is not so big, but third is the biggest chapter because it's a sadhana pada. Sadhana is really quite vast, whether it is for Brahmaloka gati or whether here and now jivan mukti. Amnayante samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam ananda khanam apurnamatma jyoti rupasmahi. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada, Prabhupada. Namaste.